Should you have sold the news on the Bitcoin ETF crisis at Ethereum due to a bug? And Solana Saga number 2 is coming soon. That and more in the Crypto Talk this week. In this week's episode, we will talk about some developments on the Bitcoin price. We will talk about Ethereum as well, and then at the end we'll quickly talk about Solana. Let's jump right into Bitcoin. Firstly, FTX estate sold most of its Grayscale Bitcoin trust shares. Now, we've talked about the first couple of days of Bitcoin spot ETF trading in terms of trading volume, and one particular spot ETF was always the highest. It was the Grayscale, the previous Bitcoin trust, that was the highest, although it had the highest fees. Now, a lot of people were saying this wasn't actually inflows, it was mostly outflows, so kind of people selling their shares in order to get out of the trade. Now, it looks very much like the FTX estate was a major seller in this part. They held 22 million shares of GBTC and sold 2/3 of it already. Currently, they have around $281 million worth of GBTC shares left, and they might actually sell it in the coming days. Now, reason for this is, of course, the FTX estate needs money. After the bankruptcy, they kind of looked at all the numbers in the books and realized the GBTC trade was quite the expensive trade. Now, since GBTC is actually tradable and you can get out of the trade, it looks very much like the FTX estate is going to capitalize on the Bitcoin price. And that, of course, has caused some Bitcoin prices to drop as well. Now, if we look at the other developments with the FTX partner, Alameda Research, who had the same management, same bank accounts, of course, and is also under scrutiny right now due to the whole situation with FTX, they actually also went to the court against GBTC, or specifically Grayscale. They said actually the fees were too high, and that was in March 23, so all before the GBTC spot ETF was actually live. They said it already for the Bitcoin Trust product, and here they are actually saying, well, we'll drop the case because we are seeing outflows and FTX has sold most of the money, so it looks very much like the legal case at least is gone. Now, what does that mean for the Bitcoin price specifically? We're currently looking at a drop of around 20% from more or less the top of the Bitcoin spot ETF. It's a bit more, it's around 21 to 22% in total, but currently the price sits at $39,000. Now, I said it won't drop below 40. It has shortly dropped below 40. And now the question is, will it stay there? Because I don't believe it will. And the selling right now is just temporary. Raoul Paul, a big macro investor, is saying, interestingly, remember, no leverage, no FOMO, of course. These are some of his rules, but also expect 35% minus, so 35% pullbacks frequently, and buy the dip if you can. And currently we're sitting at 20%, and the question is, are you buying the dip right now? Because it looks like Raoul Paul is actually very convinced that the Bitcoin price, including the entire crypto run, is actually going higher soon. Now, let's talk about Ethereum. Ethereum had an interesting couple of days. While it was higher than Bitcoin in terms of percentage points just a couple of days before the correction set in, there was an interesting outage that caused 8% of Ethereum's validator to worry. And it was actually all on the testnet. It never happened on the mainnet. They did release a new version onto the testnets, and that caused some technical troubles. Now, a lot of people are saying, what if this happens on mainnet? What if 8% of Ethereum validators go down? Is this actually the Achilles heel of Ethereum? This is a big discussion that is happening right now, and that coupled with the fact that the Ethereum Foundation actually sold $1.6 million of ETH in order to get DAI, the stable coin, is causing some trouble. Now, if we look at Ethereum's price, we're still very nice in the range. Now, Ethereum, of course, has gone higher than the original range, but currently we're still within that range. And I do believe the 2140s is an interesting entry point for every person that wants to go midterm to long term. Because don't forget, in May, we will actually potentially have a discussion of an Ethereum ETF that might come fairly soon. And next up, we have Solana. Now, Solana, it has been quiet for Solana for quite some time. Last couple of days was actually all the shine on Bitcoin and Ethereum. And Solana has actually dropped an interesting news apart. They actually said they will sell their second crypto smartphone. The Solana Saga 2 has opened up pre-orders. And right now, it actually doesn't look too bad. 40,000 pre-orders and counting. And the reason being very simple. They coupled it with airdrops. If you bought a Solana Saga phone for, let's say, around $599, at this time, right now of this recording, the phone's worth of airdrops that you would receive is around $1,300 to $1,400 based on the different airdrops. So that means it can be combined. So airdrops with hardware to actually get kind of the first user advantage. And a lot of people are banking on the same thing. Solana Saga Phone 2 with 40,000 pre-orders right now. Now, what does that mean for the Solana price? And you remember, we were still in a very positive trend line. The trend line officially has been broken, and now it will be quite interesting to see where is Solana heading, because right now it might actually be an interesting time for Solana. Now, if we do a Fib retracement here and look at the prices at here, we can actually see there is still some way to go that could be of interest. So the $50 line could be of major interest. Then we have reached 125-ish just shortly after, and then kind of the higher end of the Fib retracement would be $157. So this could actually be an interesting part where Solana is getting down to $50. And don't forget, Solana, Avalanche, and Polygon are actually the three coins with the strongest narratives right now if we're talking about gaming, AI, and real world asset tokenization. So that was it from the crypto talk this week. Important this week in Zurich at the Congress House, I will do a short presentation about cryptos getting into the Champions League, whether we've reached mainstream. It is important that you sign up for this, of course. You can watch it online or you can watch it in person. And with the link in the description, you can sign up, and I would love to see you at the presentation. So make sure that you're at the Swissquote Trading Day 2024. I will see you on the next one. Have a good one.